Collegiate.
Did you end up doing the dolphin thing?
Yeah, we did. And it was great.
Oh, good.
We went to heaven and we ended up just going to the
Short?
Yeah. Something in the future that must have disagreed with me. And I was okay. I didn't drink it.
To that little
no, spot. I got sick like while driving to
the oh, from all the fumes.
Maybe,
probably.
My stomach
was
horrible.
Yeah, Kelly was not feeling too good because of the fumes. Yeah. We hired a car with a turtle.
Yeah.
And it was one of those, it was a 1957 Ford.
Yeah.
Got almost into Cuba, and all of a sudden, we back the car in the spring or something going on. So he crawled us into the town, and then we fixed while we were there. The exhaust fumes were terrible.
I almost cracked it on the bus from just I must have eaten something weird or yeah, overall, I mean, that aside, you started researching.
Yeah, no, we're, I go back any day.
Yeah, oh yeah, me too. I keep looking at it like,
I think
when's March break again?
Yeah, I think we're thinking of doing the blout next week.
Yeah, yeah.
This is more moderate. I just switched over from to adult owner.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I can't remember what I said, because there were lots of water crews that were there. I just thought the building looking like it should be just still.
But it was more modern, though.
Was it on the inside?
Yeah. Well, at least you said it was
nice. It was so nice. I go back and
forth. Oh, yeah.
It's hard to go wrong with matches like that.
I know, it was amazing.
Yeah.
No. Sorry, say that again.
We have two drumlines.
Yeah.
So these guys are done now. We can.
Well, that's it. I thought this was a combination of two drumlines.
This is just the first one.
Okay. And they're only doing the one piece.
And that's it. So you can talk to them now, or we can bring up the other group, and however you want
to. Yeah, let's bring in the other group, and then I'll do everybody afterwards. Something's tickling her.
Yeah, for the last year.
Thank you.
on the planet should play some sort of a drum. I honestly believe that. Every musician, that's a no-brainer. They should all play some sort of drums. Because this is to get in touch with rhythm. I think if everybody played drums, there may be less frustrated people out there in the world. And we probably have a more communal sense, because if there's one thing drums do, man, it brings people together. Drums, rhythm, and it's unique in that most people love drums, or love seeing drums, or hearing drums, or dancing to drums. And, you know, aside from the human voice, some form of drum is the oldest percussion instrument known to mankind. It's been, drums and the voice have been around since human beings have been on the planet. Rhythms evolved with us. So I'm happy to see that drums still play such a pivotal role in society and in music. Now that said, I'm probably the least qualified person, even though I've played drum set for 42 years. Drumline is something that I really have very little knowledge of, because I've never been in a drumline. I played a drum kit thing once with a drumline 2 years ago for the Beaches Jazz Festival, and it was pretty cool. I know Michael Beauclair, who I think did some work with you guys.
Absolutely.
He knows way more about this stuff than me, and Brad Kilpatrick. Those are the two guys that really do that. However, I do know a lot about rhythm. So why don't we start there? I thought you guys did pretty good. Now, you guys are going to have to explain to me, first of all, when you're playing snare drum and this kind of thing, Michael, in terms of... I do that all the time. In terms of technique, obviously there's a visual thing for snare drum, right? And it's kind of like a militaristic visual spelling in that, from what I've seen, it's very regimented and it has to look a certain way, right? So you guys are doing a nice job on that. What I'm unclear of is how much he has told you to utilize the concept of rebounding when you're playing. Did Michael discuss that kind of thing with you?
Yeah, he came, 4 years ago, so it was only, it was only two of us that were at that workshop.
Okay, well my question is, from playing drum kit, I'm not saying...
Thank you.
on the right track for the motion. Just let me see. Pick a thing. I can just watch your hands real close. So I can check your technique. Just pick something that we can all pre-order. Yeah, sure. Let me see that. Just
the answer.
Sure. Is that everybody knows everybody else's part. Do you ever go around and switch? Might be something to do at the end of the rehearsal, last 5-10 minutes. So I'm going to go over here and do this part, and you're going to go over here and do this part. I mean, a little bit different technique on these drums from these ones. But it lets you know, oh, I didn't know you guys were doing this here. Because when we're doing this, I'm just thinking about my thing. Right? So I know, how many of you are actually drummers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that's good. I wasn't sure because I know in the last group there was only one. But as a listener, it helps your part be more solid rhythmically if you know what the other person's doing. Right? It's like, again, as I said, two dancers working together. If you know the footwork of the other person, then you can be better in sync. But if you don't, then you're kind of guessing. So if you're just focusing on your part and not listening to them, and they're not listening to you, then there can be discrepancies in time. So it's up to you two guys to hold the glue in the middle to hold everything together. And then, but when you guys get rocking on the big boomy bass sounds, and it gets fast and loud and syncopated, then we lose the clarity of when it's just boom, boom, grat, boom, boom. We can hear that there's space, but the busier you guys get, and the louder it gets harder to do this. So if you know what their part is, and you know what their part is, then you can hear how it all works together. So now you, my friend, you got one of the most brutal gigs, playing the piatti, as it's called, Italian for cymbals. That's super hard to play. I mean, you got muscles, because you're holding these pieces of metals, and you're trying to clip them real chup. There were a few timing errors in there in one of the tunes where there's a lot of eighth notes. So you have to really kind of be on the ball in terms of pulse and subdivisions. When you're playing, let me see how you're playing those eighth notes. Twice as fast. There was one. Okay. Generally, the way that they do that, I have seen guys do it, is there's a motion involved, and it's. I thought the sticks were heavy. Hold it super tight. Is there go. Hard to reset, especially if you're playing back past eighth notes. So this, the air escapes a little bit. And as I say, you're going to be looking like Arnold Schwarzenegger in about 6 months. Just from holding them in that situation. But super hard, but great responsibility, because you're the sound that really helps cut through all the lower. You've got the lower drums, the lower bass drums, high snare drums, so they're going to cut, and you're going to cut. So you're kind of the connector, sonically, with these guys for the high end of the pieces. So it's really important that you line up with them. You know, so you got to be very careful with that. Bass drums, the odd time, it gets a little bit washy, but I mean, I'm not sure if that's the sound of the drums themselves. You got lots of. Oh man, which one are you here? Bass drums.
Third line.
Are you guys both playing the same thing?
No,
or have you got different parts?
Different parts.
Okay. Okay. So
there's spaces. So first, second, third, fourth.
Oh, okay. Oh wow. Okay. Yeah. That's a hard reach. So, the same thing. So, is this the normal way to set them up with this?
We also did see one guy at a competition who had three stacked on top of each other, and he was just
like, "Oh yeah,
yeah." Just
oh
like,
yeah, I mean, I guess, as I say, I mean, I'm not familiar with the proper setup of these things, but you want to facilitate if there's a lot of motion, you want to facilitate the easiest way to get around the instrument. You know, again, ergonomics. So for me, that's a big stretch. And if you want to really get the proper sound of the drum, you got full extension, and to get back here, I guess you have to choose where you're going to hit the drum, and that would be, you're going to have to, if you're going between the two, you're going to have to hit on this far side. You wouldn't be going down here. You'd hit here and here, so you have the least amount of movement. Tempo. So let's do it right here. One. memorized. Oh, professionals. Professionals. So, getting around these things. Group one, group two. 6%? Why? Sped up? Okay, were you nervous? Okay, so what happens when you're nervous is your body has what's called an adrenaline spike. Right? It's just something that happens to us when we get excited about performance and anxiety. But yeah, adrenaline spike makes us want to do things faster. But it's also what happens when your brain also releases dopamine and slows down and you get paralyzed. So you've got this adrenaline pumping to make you go faster, but also your body is counteracting the physicality of it, which is why sometimes you get frightened or afraid or in shock. You can't move. The body's got all these chemical imbalances going on. So when you're nervous, why do you think you're nervous? Because you're afraid of failing in front of people. It's embarrassing. Right? You're going to say, oh my gosh, just people are looking at us, they're watching us. Don't think of it. It's ultimately, that's not even important. What's important is being in the moment as you play. Meaning, because if you're thinking about what other people think about you, you're not focusing on what you're supposed to be doing, which means you're not in the moment. You're outside of the moment. Does that make sense? You understand what I'm saying? You've got to be in it. And as soon as you start, think about drums, nothing else. And then you focus, and then when it's done, then you can go, oh, I don't even know what happened. But maybe, was that good or bad? I can't even tell. Because you were so focused, you just boom, 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 and you get through. Let me hear your piece again. From the beginning.
Four pieces.
Okay, pick the hardest part. Where's the hardest part? Where's the part where you're most afraid of?